Thank you for the invitation to come here. I am the older brother of Chief Lokandile Kardina and the older brother of Bishop Ambodari. All of us studied at San Jose Seminary, and if you see some Jesuit thinking in my mind, in my talk, blame the Jesuits. My talk is about Church of the Poor and for the Poor, one of the significant sections of Joy of the Gospel Evangelii Gaudium. When it is a round thing like this, I do not know. In a church, when I preach in a round chapel, I don't know which to face. I'm very sorry, but it seems that the podium is here. Can you hear me there? Good, thank you very much. I come from Cotabato. I am from Mindanao. I speak Ilonggo, mostly Ilonggo, a little bit of Cebuano. I am not very good in Tagalog. Very poor in Tagalog. Failing grade, 65 years old, grade year. In dreaming of a church of the poor and for the poor, Pope Francis brings to center stage what is a footnote in Western theology. In Europe, in America, North America, it's only a footnote. What is a church of the poor? Pero sa Latin America, Asia, Africa, that footnote is a very strong theological point for the church in Africa, Asia, and South America because of the poverty of people. In the North, Western theology is probably incorporated into Western society and life, well-developed countries. But Pope Francis, coming from South America, brings to the church in Rome, into the universal church, that footnote and brings it into center stage. His first apostolic exhortation, Joy of the Gospel, Evangelii Gaudium, has a major section on the social dimension of the Joy of the Gospel, especially history of making the church a church of the poor. Let me make a personal comment on this papal document, Joy of the Gospel. Never in my life as a priest for 50 years, and I am 50 years as a priest, last year. You were all invited to that golden jubilee, but none of you seem to have appeared. Whenever you go to Cotabato, you are safe in Cotabato. If you are far away from Cotabato, in Manila, in Central Luzon, sometimes in the Visayas, and outside Cotabato, people are afraid to go to Cotabato. Especially foreigners, the foreign embassies tell their citizens, do not go to Mindanao and do not go to Cotabato, most especially. But I assure you, you will be safe there. You will not be a target. Why? Because, number one, first of all, you must go not as a rich man. Number two, do not go not as a rich man, but as a poor, ordinary citizen, mingling with people. You will not be a target of kidnapping. And if you are a soldier, dress up as a civilian, because the BIFF might walk you. Barcelona is Islamic freedom fighters. If you are a priest or sister, you cannot only visit, please volunteer to work in Cotabato. Anybody want to work in Cotabato? I will work there only through obedience, sabi ng mga iba. No, volunteer, have the joy of the gospel, go there. Go forth, as Francis says. This Evangelii Gaudium is truly remarkable. It avoids ecclesiastical hierarchy. Thai language. Why is it that Bishop's pastoral letters in the Philippines, Vatican II documents, encyclicals, papal exhortations are not read because they are not only couched in language that is very high, but the thoughts are very high. Here, very simple, radical style, personal style, honest, blunt, frank, and simple to understand. Quotable quotes. Quotable quotes. One quote you know. I dream of a church that is bruised and wounded. Things like that. Or if you are an evangelizer and you bring the good news to people, do not bring the good news with a face that is coming from a funeral. And if you're a priest, quotable quote, if you're a priest, bring the joy of the gospel to the sacrament of reconciliation. Do not make the confessional box a torture chamber. Quotable quote. And that apostolic exhortation, if you have not yet read it, read it. Very simple to understand. I can understand it myself. I will understand very much that kind of documents. You have to analyze, parse the way Bishop Ambo explained the Gospels to us. Wow, he's a good teacher.